I wanted to share a little New Year's Eve message with you. Something to think about as we go through this year, 2021. We're, I think, entering into a rough patch, and I think it's going to be really a good idea to have something to think about. So, one of the things that I think we're all going to come to appreciate as we go through this period of time this next year is our, where's peace? How do we get peace? And is it going to happen? Is it worth going after that peace? And yes, it is. And so I got to thinking about, okay, what would be something that I could hang on to that about peace that makes it worthwhile. And so I came up with this list. So I'm going to share this list with you. If we didn't have war and we had peace and there was no fighting, it would mean that mothers and fathers would no longer have to send their children off to war to kill people that they don't want to kill and don't even really know. It would mean that billions of dollars would become available for projects that make sense and rejuvenate the world. We might be able to get to know many more people around the planet and work together to build good relationships. We could stop trying to steal one another's gold and silver. We could stop trying to get control of other people's natural resources. Whatever that is, water, soil, food. We would not have the horror of seeing our children come home with missing arms, missing legs, or missing eyes. We might redirect our attention to cooperation instead of competition. We could train armies of helpers instead of armies of fighters. We would be able to end the financial imbalance that results when we subscribe to false concepts of winners, losers, and pyramid power. We would be able to address the problems caused by the 1% and reassert some financial common sense. We would be able to do something about the multinational corporations that operate above the law. We could build a powerful global internet system that wouldn't have to worry about being blown up or shut off by military squabbles or other fragile aspects of our current communication system. We could educate people to go beyond the need for control by giving everyone control of their own life, and instead of letting them sink or swim, teach everybody to swim. We could have open and transparent communication between and among all of us. We could have fewer children without fathers and sometimes mothers. We would have less PTSD to deal with. We could build whole new cities and infrastructure instead of whole new aircraft carriers and missiles. We could focus on research into consciousness instead of research into bigger weapons. We could feed everyone on the planet. We could develop technology to heal instead of destroy. We could create an entirely new education system for all people to use freely at will from the cradle to the grave. We would be able to develop individuals as unique humans with a gift to give to the world instead of trying to mold people into lockstep thinking and then they never get out of the box. We would be able to transform the companies that hypnotize us into believing they own the rights to everything that we need to survive. What is that about? We would be able to reduce population if we wanted to by increasing and expanding education and opportunity. we would be able to cut the number of giant corporations that dig, extract, melt, mold, shape, ship, and sell the stuff that they've convinced us we need to buy. We could learn new ways to manufacture things that do not require the rape of the planet. We could end the propaganda pulp that convinces us we need to fear our neighbors across the sea or the city. We could get past the acceptance of strongmen and bowing to their demands. We could develop technologies that allow us to explore the solar system and meet the neighbors. We could find the time to research and develop frequency technology that provides us with energy, yet does not make us or our planet sick. We could pay attention to our governance system to prevent it from becoming corrupt. We could design a governance system that nurtures highly developed humans as their major source of capital. We could grow gardens overflowing with herbs, flowers, and high-density nutrition vegetables and feed ourselves in ways that restore high-function immune systems. We could learn to trust one another and to laugh, to love, and to dance through life in ways that we have long forgotten. So think about some of those. Think about this next year. What could we have if we got to a point of peace? And Happy New Year to everyone.